In my earlier video, I had discussed about unity offering and units offering. And today I will discuss this topic elaborately. But at first I will recommend you, please see my earlier video with pay attention. And I have given this link in my description box. Consider set of all n cross n matrices with real entries and also complex entries. And this is obviously ring under the matrix addition and matrix multiplication. And these are ring with unity since the identity matrix acts the multiplicative identity of the matrix multiplication. Okay. On the other hand, these ring are non-commutative ring since matrix multiplication is a non-commutative. That means when we say about a ring is non-commutative or commutative, when we are describing the multiplication of the ring, because the addition is always commutative. Okay. Now look at the ring 2 cross 2 matrices whose entries are in integer. Most of the matrices in the ring don't have a multiplicative inverse. As for example, if we consider this matrix, this inverse would be minus 2, 1, 3 over 2, minus 1 over 2, which does not belong to this ring. But if you consider this matrix, then this inverse be the member of this ring. And notice here, multiply these two matrix, here this is identity. Similarly, here left multiply and here right multiply. Similarly, this is equal to identity. That means this matrix be the unit of this ring. Okay, therefore this ring has infinite group of unit. Okay, and this is actually the those matrix whose determinant is plus minus 1. Okay, well, actually in general for n cross n matrices the units are general linear group. Now okay. I will say new concept of the ring. Zero divisor of a ring. A zero divisor is a non-zero element of the ring R such that there is a non-zero element B in R such that multiplication of this element is equal to zero. That means A not equal to zero. Also there exists a element B in ring which is also not equal to zero. But their product equal to zero. Okay. For example, if you consider the Z8 group which contain 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the group of modulo 8. Here 4 times 2 equal to 0. Similarly 2 times 4 equal to 0. And these two guys are here zero divisor. Okay. Other example, consider this direct sum. This is denoted as the ring R. Here the operation is look like AB plus CD equal to A plus C comma B plus D and AB times CD equal to AC comma BD. Okay. If you pick two element 0, 3 and 6, 0, then their multiplication would be 0, 0. Okay. That means these two guys are zero divisor in this ring. Are you getting this idea of the zero divisor? I will see one nice observation. Consider 2×2 matrices with real entries. Then set of units be the set of those matrices whose determinant is non-zero. And zero divisor be the set of those matrices whose determinant is equal to zero. For this, just see the proof. Consider AB non-zero matrix and BB also non-zero matrix. Okay? Such that their product be zero. We all of us know this is the definition of zero divisor. And now I will prove this by contradiction. Suppose A has a unit. That means that implies A has a multiplicative inverse. Now let's multiply this equation by A inverse. Then this would be A inverse times AB, which is equal to A inverse times 0, 0. Okay? And we all of us know this is equal to just identity matrix. That implies from this line, B equal to, by multiplying this would be 0, 0. Okay? But here notice, I have got B equal to 0, 0 matrix. But I have assumed B is not a 0 matrix. So our assumption A has a unit is a wrong assumption. That implies A does not have a inverse. So determinant of A equal to 0 by the definition of invertible matrix. Okay? Similarly, we can prove A is unit if determinant of A not equal to 0. Therefore, by this observation, we can find any unit and zero divisor of a matrix ring. There is a nice observation. If A belongs to ring, is not a unit, that implies it is not a zero divisor. Similarly, if A belongs to R, is a zero divisor, that also implies it is not a unit. Okay? Let's see the proof. Suppose A belongs to any element ring, which is a unit. Then there exists B belongs to ring such that AB equal to 0. Now multiply both sides the equation by A inverse, then this would be A inverse times AB, which is equal to A inverse times 0. And we can reassociate it, then it would be A inverse times A times B equal to 0, and this is equal to just identity, that implies B equal to 0. And for zero divisor, here obviously B not equal to 0, but here I have got B equal to 0. Therefore, A cannot be zero divisor if A is unit. Okay? Are you getting the proof? See one nice observation. In my earlier video, I had seen the units of the ring Zn are those elements which are prime to n. Now, I will say what is the divisor of 0 in Zn. In the ring Zn, divisor of 0 are precisely those elements which are not relatively prime to n. Are you getting? Well, see one corollary. If P is a prime number, then obviously ZP has no divisor of 0. Because ZP contains 0, 1, 2 up to P minus 1. Since here P is a prime number, so ZP contains those elements which are prime to P. So if P is a prime number, then ZP has no divisor of 0. Then all the elements of ZP are units. As for example, let's see, find the divisor of 0 in the ring Z18. Which element would be divisor of 0 of Z modulo 18? Those elements in Z18 which are not relatively prime to Z18. And these are just 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16. My all viewers have understood the idea of divisor. Now I will see new concept, no zero divisor. A ring R is said to have no zero divisor if AB equal to 0. That implies either A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. In divisor of 0, both A and B are non-zero element. But here, either A or B are zero element. For example, consider the ring Z3, which contains element 0, 1, 2. And notice, here the non-zero element be 1 and 2. But 1 times 2 in modulo 3 does not congruent to 0. But if we take the element 0 and 1, then 0 times 1 equal to 0, and also 0 times 2 equal to 0. Means this ring Z3 has no divisor of 0. Are you getting the concept of no divisor of 0? Now I will see one nice example in ring. Solve the equation xr cube minus 2x square minus 3x equal to 0 in the ring Z12. After factorizing, this equation would be x times x square minus 2x minus 3 equal to 0. If we again factorize, then this equation would be x times x minus 3 times x plus 1 equal to 0. And if any of integer is equal to 0, then their product must be equal to 0. So this is possible either x equal to 0 or x equal to 3 or x equal to minus 1. When x equal to 0, then this, since this term would be equal to 0, so their product must be equal to 0. And when x equal to 3, since this term would x minus 3, this would be 0, so their product must be also equal to 0. And when x equal to minus 1, then this term would be equal to 0, so their product obviously would be equal to 0. Okay? So either x equal to 0 or x equal to 3 or x equal to minus 1 be solution in this equation in Z12. And notice, minus 1 be the additive inverse in Z12. Because 1 plus 11 equal to 12, which is congruent to 0 in the ring Z12. Okay? So we can write this is congruent to 11 in the ring Z12, mod 12. Okay? So 11 also be the solution of this equation. Getting the idea? Solution of an equation in the ring? Well, now let's check, is there exist other solution of this equation in Z12? Put the element, other element x equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. After putting in this equation, I have got, just see, only at the point x equal to 5, the value is congruent to 0 in Z12. Similarly, at the point x equal to 8, the value is equal to 0. And at the point x equal to 9, also the value is equal to 0. So, x equal to 8, 9 and 5 also be solution of this equation. Are you getting the method? How we have to find solution of a equation in a ring? Okay. Today I will stop here. And in my next video, I will discuss this topic again elaborately. Because this concept is very important to understand the algebraic structure of ring clearly. See you soon. Stay safe and stay positive always.